Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson, Matter Around Us. See, students, in my first session, in first lecture, I have explained you what is meant by matter. In olden days, what were the sayings of the matter? Okay. Later on, I let you know. Later on, the new concept of the, or the modern concept of the matter. Now. After it, I have talked about the physical nature of matter. Okay, I have talked about physical nature of matter. In that physical nature of matter, I said you the first point, that is matter is made up of particle. Matter is made up of particles. See, students, pay attention properly, because first lecture what I said you, what is the concept of matter? What was the concept, old concept of the matter, which was said by our old philosophers, right? Later on, I explain you the modern concept of matter. Okay. Later on, we are going to talk about now the physical nature of the matter. The physical nature of the matter is, first, matter is made up of particles, right? For that sake, I gave you example of the lemonade. Okay, what we have done in that, first, we have taken a small beaker, we have added sugar in it, salt in it, and lemon juice in it, and we stir it. After some time, when we stir it, all the particles of the salt and sugar were completely dissolved in it, as well as some lemon juice particles also completely dissolved in it. Where does particle have gone? This particle have occupied the space between the water molecule, and the particle size is too small that we are unable to see it with our naked eyes. Understood? Because the size of the particle is too small. What is exactly the size, that we will explain it into the next lesson, that is matter around us pure. At that time, students, it will be more clearer for you. But till here, you keep in mind that physical nature of matter, the first thing is matter is made up of particle, that already I have explained you in my previous session. Now, the second point related to the physical nature of matter is that the size of the particle is so small, or too small we can say. So how I will write the point? Particles of the matters are too small. Okay, my point will be, particles of the matter are too small. Okay, or in your textbook, if you will see on the first page only, in the form of activity, before the activity, it is given that how the particles of matters are. Okay, and in your book, you may read textbook also, but I will explain you this property of the physical nature of matter by one small example. Okay, here, students. So, what I would do here to explain you how particles of the matter is so small, or the particle size of the matter is too small. How can I explain you that? For that sake, what we will do, we will take one beaker. Students, observe it very carefully. It's very important. If you see here and there, then it won't be able to understand for you. So, please pay attention. Okay. What I will do, I will take here 100 ml beaker I would take, and I would add a 100 ml water in, or I would take 200 ml beaker, okay, or 250 ml beaker. The capacity of that beaker is occupied the solution of 250 ml, or any solvent of 250 ml, and I have added a 100 ml of water in it, okay, and this is the first beaker. Okay, students, what I have done, I have taken a beaker which was of 250 ml, and I have added 100 ml of water in it. Okay. Now, in that beaker only, I am going to add any color stain. Now, here I have chosen, on your textbook also it is given, that is KMnO4 crystals. KMnO4 crystals. KMnO4 means what? Potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate. Okay? Potassium permanganate. What is it exactly? We will come to know in your higher classes. So, just till now, just you keep in mind that potassium permanganate are of pinkish color crystals. Are of pinkish color crystals. Okay? Small, small crystals are there. What I would do? I would take a small amount of, very small amount of crystals. Say 25 gram or 20 gram of crystals I would add in it. As they are wearing the color pinkish, after adding it, the solution will be pinkish. Do you get me? We are doing this on the Ranga Panchami day. Very soon, just now you have gone through it while playing the colors. You have seen that we are taking a water, we are adding some color in it. After some time, if you will see, the color is uniformly spread everywhere. So same we have to do here. Okay. So what will happen after some time, if you have a closer look on it, the color of this solution will be dark pink. Dark pink. Okay. Now what we have to do next? We have to take another beaker over here. We have to take another beaker, which is of also 100 ml. And what I have to do? I have to take now 250 ml beaker same. And I have to add 100 ml of water in it. Again, I have to add 100 ml of water in it. Or I may take 90 ml also. I may take 90 ml of water in it. Plain water. Plain water, which is not colored. And what I have to do, I have to take one measurement of 10 ml. Okay, I may take anything. I may take small beaker or I may take a small test tube, but it should be of only 10 ml. Okay, what I will do, I will take a 10 ml from the first beaker. This is beaker number 2. Okay, and this is 10 ml from the first beaker. I would collect into small beaker or I may collect into the small test tube. And now what I would do, this 10 ml, I would add into this second beaker. 10 ml from first beaker I would take and I will pour in it. I will pour in it. Students, what will be your observation when I will pour the solution from the first beaker into the second beaker? What might be happening? Can anyone tell me? Okay. See, this lecture is recorded, so you cannot tell. But I hope you might have understood that this solution will be colored. This solution will be colored. But student, if you have a closer look in it, then the intensity of the color would be more into the first beaker than the second beaker. Means it will be little fainter than first one. That much only the difference. But still colored particles are there. Do you understand, students, what I say? In the first beaker, the intensity of the color would be more. While in the second beaker, the intensity of the color would be less. But still, the beaker or the solution into the second beaker is still colored. Okay, now what we will do? We will take third beaker. Again, the same procedure I will follow, students. Again, I will take the beaker of 250 ml. Okay, and again, I will add 90 ml water in it. Okay, and from the second beaker, which is little faint in color, I'll take 10 ml from each and I shall add into the third beaker. Now what might be the difference, students? The solution will be much fainter. It will be less color. It will be less color. Right, student? So intensity of the color is first more, in second little less, and in third less color. Okay, and if we go on doing, then too the particles of the potassium permanganate, which we have taken only 20 gram, still the solution is being colored. If you will take 4-5 beaker, if you will take 10 beakers, then we will find that there is no color into the beaker. What does this activity show? What does this activity show? This activity is showing that the size or the particles of the matter are too small that they are occupying the space. Okay, the particle size is too much small, means if we will go on dividing them, they will go on dividing and they will try to occupy the space between the water molecule or somewhere else. Here I have taken just an example. We can take an example of even our gas. See students, what we are doing at our home, in the evening we do puja, right? And we burn essence stick we are burning. And in the corner, wherever we are doing our puja, there we are burning it. But after some time, you will observe that the smell, the fragrance of that essence stick will spread everywhere uniformly. What does this explain? The size of the particle is too small. So that is the example of the gaseous state, and this is the example of the liquid state. So I hope you understand this physical nature of matter. The first point is matter is made up of particle, and second is particles of the matter are too small. Okay students, now we will go ahead for the characteristics of the particles of matter. Characteristics of the particles of matter. Now we will see characteristics of particles of matter. See here on the second page, the characteristics of particles of matter are given along with some activities. Okay, so here I would like to clear this point first. What are the characteristics of particles of matter? Okay, the first characteristic of particle of matter is particles of matter have space between them. Second characteristic is particles of matter are continuously moving. Particles of matter are continuously moving. And the third characteristic is that particles of matter attract each other. Okay student, now one by one with the help of activity again I would explain you. Please pay attention, don't go anywhere, listen to me very carefully, it's very important. Now first we will talk about particles of matter have a space between them. See students, as when I said you the physical nature of matter, at that time I gave you example of a laminate. Okay, and just now also I have given you example of a laminate. When you have added, again I would like to take a 250 ml. 250 ml is favorite for me, so I have taken it because it occupies a much amount of solution in it. Okay, so and we can see experiment very clearly. So I have taken 250 ml of beaker. In that I have added, again I have added 100 ml of water. 100 ml of water. I have added 1 teaspoon sugar, 1 teaspoon salt, and I have added 2 teaspoons of lemon juice. Okay student, lemon juice. Now I have added everything in it. Now it's a solution. It is a solution of sugar, salt, lemon juice. So it is called as together lemonade. Lemonade or lemon juice simply we say. We drink it, right? We drink it now to get energy immediately because salt and sugar is there, lemon juice is there, vitamin C is there, which increase the our immunity power. Nowadays in during COVID situation, we should drink this frequently because this is the water soluble vitamin, and this water soluble vitamin, when we urinate it, pass it out, so that we should drink it time to time on a daily basis. Okay, so this is the lemonade I have prepared. I have brought in middle biology, sorry students, but here to explain you and to just grab your attention, I should add some sentences in it. Okay, so what I have done, I have taken 100 ml of water, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, and 2 teaspoons of juice, lemon juice. Now if I will taste it, it will have a watery taste, it will have a salty taste, it will have a sweet taste. At the same time, it will have a sour taste too. It will have a sour taste too, right? So it will be a mixture of all the taste. But if we will try to look towards those particles which I have added previously, you won't be able to see the particles, right? You won't be able to see the salt particles. You won't be able to see the sugar particles. You won't be even able to see the particles of the lemon juice. Where does they have gone? Where they have gone? They have occupied the space between the water molecule. They have occupied the space between the water molecule. This activity proves that particles of matter have space between them. Okay students, I hope this is clear for you. Shall we go for the next characteristic of particles of matter? Okay students, I shall go for the next characteristic. Next characteristic. That is, particles of matter are continuously moving. Okay. Here, I will explain this characteristic through various ways. Because particle of matter, the definition of matter, please do not forget the definition of matter. Definition of matter is what? Which we have learned. Matter, the thing or the matter which is occupying some space and has mass. So it may be into the solid state, it may be into the liquid state, or it may be into the gaseous state. So we are going to talk about all particles of things, all states of matter. Okay. So here what we will do, we will take again one beaker, okay, and again we will add a potassium permanganate crystals in it, right, potassium crystals we will add, and we will wait for a while, what we have done, potassium permanganate will work as a solute and water will work as a solvent here. Solvent is the substance which is in a more amount, okay, and into the solvent, the solute is dissolved. This concept will be clear more in the second lesson. Till now, just keep in mind that if this is the solution of the potassium permanganate, then potassium permanganate will be the solute and water will be the solvent. Keep in mind, okay, students. Now, what I have done, I have added these crystals of potassium permanganate into the solvent. Now, I will not stir it. I'll keep it aside for some time. And when I will add the crystals in it, at the same extent, what will happen, student? The particles will start dissolving in it. Right? The particle will start dissolving in it. Wherever I will put the potassium permanganate crystals, from that point, the potassium permanganate crystals will start dissolving in a uniform manner. Right? It will not be found that if I have added the potassium crystals here, then potassium crystals would be here only and this part will be colored. It will not happen. What will happen? The potassium crystals will spread everywhere uniformly. After some time, if you will see, the potassium crystals have spread uniformly everywhere. Okay? What this process is called, student? I think you have not learned previously, but I will explain you. This process is called as a diffusion. Means the movement of particle from higher concentration to the lower concentration. This process is called as a diffusion. Okay, students, in next lesson it will be more clearer for you. Particles of matter are continuously moving. For that sake, this is solvent, this is potassium permanganate. I have added some crystals in it. When without stirring even, the particles will move uniformly from lower higher concentration. Here the concentration is more and outside the concentration is less. So what will happen? The particles will move from higher concentration to the lower concentration uniformly, and that process is called as a diffusion. Understood, student? That process is called as a diffusion. This is one more example. Then second one example which just now I gave you. If I will burn here in the class itself, I'm not talking at home. If here I will burn an essence matchstick, right? Essence matchstick. If I will burn essence stick, matchstick. No, essence stick. Agarbatti is saying Marathi. So that agarbatti, if I try to burn over here, the few students who are sitting in the first bench will be able to smell it first. Because of its fragrance, they will be able to smell it first. But after some time, the whole class will be able to smell it uniformly. But obviously, the students who are sitting on the first bench would be able to smell it first. But later on, the whole class would be able to smell it in the uniform manner. And this is also one more example that the particles of matter are continuously moving, students. I hope you understand. Here, one more concept I would like to clear with you, that if this is the particle, if I would use here a Bunsen burner, a burner which is giving out flame. Okay, means if I will provide a heat for this liquid, right? If I will provide heat for this solution, then what would happen, students? Can you just imagine what would happen if I would add some active crystals I have added, and if I would provide some heat to this crystals of the KMnO4 which I have added into the water? What will happen, students? The process of diffusion will be faster, because the particles which are present in it will move apart. The kinetic energy of the particle will be more. First they were in the liquid state, now they will try to come into the gaseous state, and so that the distance between them would get increased. As the distance would get increased, they will be uniform, they will be spread uniformly earlier than the previous one situation. So this will be the effect of increasing temperature onto the solution. So I hope you understand the second point, that is particles of matter are continuously moving, depends upon the states of the matter. If the particles are of gaseous state, it will be move uniformly very fast. If the particles of matter are into the liquid state, it will take little time as compared to the first gaseous state, and into the third solid state, it will require some medium to move it. Such as there are the KMnO4 particles. KMnO4 particles cannot spread uniformly of their own. It requires medium like a water. So I hope you understand the concept of particles of matter are continuously moving. Now we will go ahead for the particles of matter attract each other. See in your textbook, some Bihu women are given, right? Who are dancing. There is proper dance style of the Bihu women. You can see on the page number 3. So these women, what they have done, they have taken their hands and they have grabbed to the next women's waist. They have tried to do that. What it shows? The particles, attraction between the particles. See, this particles of matter attract each other. Here, I am going to talk a little about the states of the matter. See, there are 3 states of the matter, students. Solid, liquid and gas. And our point is particles of matter attract each other. See, suppose this is my chalk, right? If it will drop down, or if you try to break it, it will be easy for me to break it, because this is brittle in nature. Just like our earthen slab, wheat manto pantala. If you will drop it down, it can break very easily. This chalk also can break it. I don't want to break it because I have only one lump. So I will not show you how it breaks. But we have seen it. The substances which are brittle, if we drop them down easily, they can break. Even then, those are into the solid state. But if I would use this is a board. If I will try to put my finger inside, can it go inside? Can it go inside? No, students, it cannot go inside. Suppose this is a duster, I am trying to put my finger into the duster. Can it go inside? it will also not go inside. Why it is so? Because the particles are closely, tightly packed. There is no gap between the particles of matter. Means I feel I push here, if I put my finger in it, I cannot be able to move inside because the solids have a attraction. A strong molecular force of attraction is present in it. This is the case of the solid. If I will take a water in it, again it will be 250 ml, right? And if I will take 100 ml of water, and if I try to put my finger inside, can it go, students, easily? Yes, it can easily pass through it because the particles of the matter, means the attraction, is less as compared to the solid state. Because there is a gap in between the particles and I can put my finger inside. So I hope you understand. In third case, I can move my hand nicely. There is air. I can move my hand very freely. I can move my hand. How it is possible? Because air, in the particles of air, is no gap in it. Understood? Or we can say very less molecular force of attraction is present into the air, or na ke barabar we can say. We can say there is no attraction between the particles of matter of the gaseous state. So I think, I hope I have tried to clear all this characteristic of particles of matter with a proper and suitable example to you. Okay, in the next session I'll go for the states of the matter. We will try to understand every state of matter in very precise manner. Thank you, students.